The Trade Minister, Mwebesa, made submissions while appearing before the Joel Senyonyi-led Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, that is investigating a string of financial scandals that rocked the standards body in the financial year 2021-2022. Mwebesa first wrote on June 26, 2023, directing a bureau to take a 6-month sabbatical to pave way for a forensic audit. However, following subsequent discussions with the National Standards Council, a body that acts as the board of UNBS led by Charles Musekura, it was resolved that the matter be handled internally. Subsequently, Ebiru's punishment was reduced to 1 month.
For them, the council took a decision for him to go on leave while the investigations are carried on. And that's why I'm saying I'm surprised. You heard it from the news that he was here and talking about the same issue.
As such, Ebiru was replaced by the deputy director in charge of standards, Patricia Bageine Ejalu, in acting capacity. But the minister was shocked to learn from the press that Ebiru declined to go on forced leave and instead displaced Ejalu.
To my knowledge, I thought 6 months would have been appropriate. And I'm sure they did take it. But we talked. There's nothing in writing, but they did what is necessary. And they sent him on leave. And as we talk here, I expect that this man is on leave.
Oh, you are saying when you came back, you spoke to the board chair and you told him and the board to take action. And what you're saying is they sent the ED on forced leave. In fact, you're surprised that the ED is here and not on leave. I'm thinking, Honorable Minister, how do you follow up on instructions that you have given? Because you also told us you have been following the committee discussions and so on, but this morning you're telling us you're surprised that the ED is here and not on forced leave.
Asked why Ebiru is still in office, the board chairman told COSASE that he disobeyed the board's resolutions and they have no force to evict him from office.
We held a meeting on the 3rd of July, and the minister, I think, had returned the previous day, and we passed the resolutions. And we passed on the resolutions to the ED, and he disobeyed them.
Committee members then descended on the minister and questioned him whether he's still in charge when his directives are falling on deaf ears.
We are saying you're the reason he's still in office.
True, I'm in charge. And you can see the whole thing was that when I got the first info about what was happening there, I had to consult the chairman, and they held the council. The council sat. And when they sat, they sent this man on leave. But the same person whom we are talking about did not go on leave.
Ejalu was appointed as acting ED last month when Ebiru was in Kinshasa, DR Congo, for a week-long standards meeting, but she told the committee that although she had been appointed, she was surprised to see her boss back in office and her role ended there.
Mentioned that Mr. Ebiru was to go on leave, and the 7th resolution said that the current acting ED, Mrs. Patricia Bageine Ejalu, should continue in the capacity of acting ED until further notice. So I received that on Friday, 7th July. On Monday, 10th July, the ED was back in office. I can only act when the position is available.
They wrote sending him on forced leave, but I'm sure he refused because council is not his appointing authority. Council, the board, is only his supervisor.
The committee resolved that the minister writes another letter, sending Ebiru on forced leave to pave way for investigations.
I'm going to put in writing and to who, so that we get it clearly.
I'm going to write to ED.
Mm-hmm.
I have received a note that a letter that you should go on leave, and up to now you have not gone on leave, only to find you here this
report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.